Hey lovelies, it's Charity from thewordofanerd.com. Happy Earth Day. Today is April 22nd, 2013, and we're actually celebrating 43 years of Earth Day. Earth Day was originally started in 1970 by Gaylord Nelson. It was just a day that they wanted to start to make people more environmentally aware of how decisions that we make and things that we purchase can have a really bad effect on the environment. It was first celebrated in 1970 in New York City, so that's also exciting to know. So I just wanted to come to you all with my Earth Day video for today. For the entire month, I've actually been posting every Monday about things that you could do to be a little bit more greener in your life. If you don't know, the United States, we celebrate Earth Day, but there are about 200 other countries all around the world that actually celebrate Earth Week. So that's why I wanted to kick off with Earth Month, because I don't think that, you know, we should just think about the Earth for one day, and not even just for one month. We need to constantly be thinking and be aware of the things that we're doing, the things that we're buying, and how they affect the Earth, you know. We need to understand the cycle of the stuff that we're buying and, you know, once we buy it, where it goes to the landfill, et cetera, et cetera. So I'm not going to get into that, but I did want to share with you all a few ways that I am green in my life. And I thought that these were things that you all could implement in your life as well, because they're pretty simple. And am I perfect at doing everything right for the Earth? No. But the point of this post, the point of Earth Day, is to become aware of the decisions that you make. So awareness brings on change. So here we go. I'll just show you some of the things that I have here set up for you. Alrighty. So let's get to talking. You see all these different things that are on the table. You're probably like, what is that? But anyway, we're going to start over here. I want to talk to you all about a change that my husband and I made this year. You know how every year when you get together for holiday parties, they have all these aluminum pans that, you know, we're eating out of, you know, because there are so many people, you probably don't have enough pans to feed your entire family, or you're just lazy. I want to say that about my family. We actually didn't have pans, but we were also lazy. We never tried to think about anything else. So I purchased these ceramic pans this year. Last year I purchased these for Thanksgiving, that I said that we would no longer use the aluminum products anymore. So we got rid of those, and we got a lot of ceramic pans. These things can go up to like 500 degrees in the oven. I never cook on 500, so that's still a blessing either way. I paid $3.99 for each one of these pans. This one and this one were $3.99. I have a few other ones. The most expensive pan that I purchased was about, I think $10.99, and that was for a ceramic Dutch oven. So this is, you know, in the beginning, these things seem like they cost a lot, but actually the aluminum pan that's about this size, this is about a 10 by 10, square pan. And they were about $4.99. So this is pretty, these are running pretty close to aluminum pans, but the fact is you get to keep these as long as you take care of them and you don't break them. They'll be around for years to come. And I know a lot of people already use ceramic pans for their family functions. That's awesome. You know, I admire people that do, and that's part of the reason why I started. So I also want to talk to you guys about paper products. We no longer use paper products at home either. Not only is it great for the environment, but it's also just great for our pockets to not have to have, you know, all those paper products, paper plates, paper cups, plastic knives, forks, and paper towels. So paper towels was one of the hardest things for us to get rid of, but we made that step and we just purchased a lot more towels in our kitchen. So we have these hand towels that we use for the kitchen and on our bathroom. We've already been using a bigger towel in the bathroom to dry our hands on, but the kitchen was where you always want to have like clean, you want to be clean, you know, in the kitchen. So these are what we use now. My mom actually purchased these. These are higher end. They have like all this texture, you know, all this different, these different patterns and things like that. And she purchased these from Target. They were on the higher end, but I'm pretty positive, because I have other towels, but I'm pretty positive you can get these towels for less than, you know, $4 for maybe two or three. Or $5.99 for two or three. You can check Marshall's, Home Goods, Target, Ross, if you have that store, TJ Maxx. There's so many different places. Wherever you buy towels from, Walmart, you can even find them there. They probably won't be as thick as these, because these are the higher end ones. I think they're about $8 for a set of two or something, but still, they all work the same. And it's also in regards to recycling. Another thing that we do is I love olives. Those are like one of my favorite snacks, and they always come in these two-part containers with the metal lid and then the glass jar. So as you can see, you can look here and see some of the jars that I actually saved. And this one was an olive jar. These were spice jars from Spice Island. And I just repurposed those jars to use them for other things. These jars, I just clean them out, clean the goop from on the front with the label and things like that. And then we spray painted the top, primed it first, spray painted them with oil rug bronze by Krylon. This is also another jar that I saved. This was actually bottled water by Voss. I hope I'm saying that right. But I don't even buy bottled water, but we were on vacation and, you know, I was very thirsty. So I got this bottled water and I held on to it. And I was like, you know, what can I use this for? Because I don't want to just throw it away. But look how thick that glass is. Like, just take a look at that. Like, look how thick that glass is. This is like quality workmanship here. So I kept this and I just used it. You can see it's Voss sparkling water. I kept this and I just used it to store my leftover spaghetti noodles, because I never use the entire pack, but I always just go ahead and get the 16 ounce and I only use like half of that. But this is how I reuse, because you don't always have to recycle. If you can reuse things, that's a great idea too. You know, that eliminates a whole process of the things going back somewhere else. You know, you can just reuse those things. Okay, and then also, another thing we do is when we go to the grocery store, we bring our own bags. That's like one of the biggest things. Now, I'll be honest with you. When we first came up, we hadn't received our shipment of all of our furniture from Florida. So, of course, we had to go to the grocery store. We needed to have these bags. So we went to Whole Foods, and, of course, they give us, you know, all these grocery bags, because we did a whole lot of shopping. You can see there's like tons of grocery bags in there. That was like from one grocery trip, because we had nothing in this apartment. So we got these grocery bags, and this is from when we first came up. Well, when I first came up was in June. So we've had these bags since June of 2012, and we take them, we put them in the car just in case when we go back, we want to, you know, get more stuff, we'll bring our bags so that we're just being a little bit more greener and more responsible. And not to mention that the Whole Foods gives you 10 cents back for every bag that you bring. So at this rate, I don't even realize that we're saving, you know, a few dollars every trip that we take because we have all these bags. These ones are actually in the house because we went grocery shopping a while ago. But this is what I have in my car right now. I'm never without bags in our car. When we were in Florida, this is what we used. We use these bags because Florida doesn't participate in that program to give you money back for bringing your own bags. They're not, you know, they're not there yet. But these bags I purchased for 99 cents from Publix. And each time I go, I would just bring my bags, you know. I have like tons of these in the car, probably about 30 or 40 of these bags. And I just bring them with me in the car. And they're very sturdy. They have like a hard insert right here to make the bag, you know, just more resilient. And, you know, I have to say nothing but good things about these reusable bags. Yes, they cost 99 cents each, but sometimes I got them on sale for like a quarter or 50 cents per bag, something like that, depending on the sale that they're having. This was from Earth Day several years ago, probably from like 2007. And as you can see, this bag is still in great condition. It actually looks brand new. But I take these bags back to the store and I just feel so much better about what I'm doing for the earth. And not to mention that I know my groceries will get home safely. I've had several times with using those plastic bags. Even the paper ones aren't as sturdy as these. But the plastic bags, I mean, I've broken olive jars, eggs, smushed my bread, have busted, knocked up canned goods, you know, all kinds of dents and bruises to my fruits. So this bag is sturdy. It can travel. I take that with me when I'm like going to the grocery store via subway, bus, whatever. And I even walk down the road with these, you know, these bags on my arms. Of course, they, you know, they're heavy, but still they hold up very well for travel purposes. So I urge you to check out your grocery stores and see what their programs are in regards to bringing your own bags. Even if they don't have a program to give you refunds for bringing your bags, still think about what you're doing for the earth and the fact that you'll be saving money and not breaking up your groceries either. Okay, and another way that we're really green is when it comes to planting. I posted a while ago that I had started my indoor garden, and I purchased these peat pots from Lowe's, and they were only about $3 for a set of, I think it was 26. And this is what I have left because I use the other ones. But these peat pots, a lot of people go and they want to buy those plastic pots to start their indoor gardens. Bad idea. I have to tell you, bad idea, because not only are they not as durable, well, they're more durable than these, of course, because these actually are biodegradable. So they're made to, you know, actually dissolve once they get into the earth, and, you know, they dissolve a lot easier. But as far as the plastic ones, they're not as durable as, say, a ceramic pot or just all the other alternatives. The plastic ones are definitely going to be in a landfill one day. They're going to be in a landfill. I don't care how long you're planting. They're not going to be as durable to hold up for several seasons of gardening as well, because as those plants get heavy and you start to pick up that pot, they're going to break. But I get these peat pots just because I know for a fact that they will, you know, they will recycle well, that they will, you know, just make my plants feel like they're in a healthier environment. Not only that, I'm not really sure if the plastic plant pots are BPA free. So if you think about that, what you're feeding your plants and they're absorbing all of these different chemicals that can come from the plastic pots, I'd just be a little careful on that. So these peat pots are awesome. Like when you, if you're planting, you're gonna plant outside, you take the pot and when you wet it, it breaks easy. Like you can break off this bottom rim and you just plant your plants into the ground. So this is what they look like on the inside. Just very simple. You put them in the ground and they're biodegradable. I use these in Florida when I had my garden. I had the bigger ones because they come in a bigger size, but these are indoor ones. I'm actually going to replant my herbs and my vegetables in bigger pots that I actually purchased from IKEA. They were ceramic. I got them for like 50 cents each. So that was so awesome. And another way that I'm conscious about how I'm green is via reading. People don't really think about that, you know. Reading is like, that is like where a lot of the paper that we use in this world is absorbed. Like just getting magazines, you know, all the junk mail that we get, books, newspapers, all that stuff goes into, you know, these landfills, because a lot of people do not recycle, you know. And of course, they're going to absorb in the landfills, but it's like you're cutting down trees every day for that purpose. So as much as people say, oh, reading is a dying art, yeah, I know the Kindle, the Nook, all these other e-readers have come out, but you know, they're more environmentally friendly. And I love a good book and I love turning pages, but I love my earth better. I love my clean air. I love the fact of knowing that the earth will be around for my children, your children, you know, our family members that are coming after us, just generations. We want to make sure the earth is around for them. So this is how I read. I read on this Nook, you know, it's a Nook color. And I purchased this one just because I know I also like to read magazines. And I could read my magazines in color on here. So if you're a person that worries about, oh, well, how will I read my magazines if I go to a Nook color? Like how will that work? Well, if I go to an e-reader, you can go to the Nook color, you can go to the Kindle. They all support, they both have models that support color reading. So you can do whatever you really need to do on these e-readers. You can browse the internet because some of them are tablet ready. You can just, there's an array of things you can do. So there's no end to that. And you just have to be willing to make the initial investment. Like I said, all of these things have an initial investment. You make the initial investment and then you're saving the earth and you're saving yourself, because some of these e-books are actually cheaper than the paper books. Especially if you have a Kindle. Kindles I can highly recommend. Even though I don't have a Kindle, I have a lot of friends that have Kindles and they're very pleased, you know, with their Kindles and the process and the prices of the books and things like that. Okay, so moving on. I wanted to talk to you guys about reusable containers. That's another thing. Like the reusable bags, you have your reusable containers. I take my reusable containers to different places. These are mine for Starbucks. As you can see, I love to drink at Starbucks. I have my Frappuccino cup, or, you know, I use these for various things. I don't usually get the Frappuccino with the whipped cream anymore, but you know, I use either of these cups when I go. These are 12-ounce cups. They keep your beverage very cool. And you also save 10 cents when you bring your cups back to Starbucks. I also bring my own bag. When I go on my date with Jesus, I'm like already, I have my Starbucks bag to put my Bible in, my snacks. I go to Starbucks and I get one of their pound cake slices, and then I get my Frappuccino and I'm good to go. And these things have their reusable straws. I'm not really that crazy about the plastic, but they do say that these are BPA free. But I'm actually working on getting rid of plastics altogether in my house. But this is my go-to cup when I'm at home. I drink out of this. It's actually a shaker. I purchased this from Home Goods a few years ago. You probably can't see that, but it says it's by Glass Lock. That's what it says. And this one has a handy measuring section where you can measure what you're drinking. If you're a person that's counting your calories and you want to just get like 4 ounces of orange juice, or know how many calories are in 8 ounces of juice, you have your measurements here, and then you can just follow your calories, count your points, whatever you might be doing. And this glass is made very thick. It's made out of tempered glass. It's taken a few tumbles and it's still alive. So that's one of the things that I use. And like I said, I'm working on getting rid of these as well. For my Earth Day celebration this year, I ordered a huge stock of mason jars for both storage in the kitchen, the freezer, as well as for drinking out of. So I can't wait to share those with you on the blog. Okay, and I'm almost done. I just want to talk to you guys really quickly about something that's probably going to be a little, you know, you're probably going to have your opinions about this, but I still want to share, especially to all my female readers. I think you'll find this kind of interesting. Maybe it'll gross you out. I'm not really sure, but anyhow, this is what I want to share. So here we go. These are cloth pads. Sorry about that. These are cloth pads. Most women have menstrual cycles for a very long time in their life, starting at about 13 if you're like me. If you're eating a lot of hormones and things like that, you maybe start a little early. Maybe start a little earlier just based on genetics as well. Let me just put that out there. But I know that because of the hormones and the food, the girls are starting their menstrual cycles a lot earlier. So I just wanted to share with you all these wonderful pads and pads and panty liners that I purchased from Gem Cloth. These are reusable. They're just like baby cloth diapers. You use them and then you wash them. Here we have the light pads. These are the pads that you would wear with your tampon or your Diva cup. And these have slight protection just to make sure you don't leak on your undies if your tampon is, you know, at its max or whatever. These are also the other pads. So you see they come in about 4 sizes. This is the light pad. This is like, I'm sorry, the camera's not even on it. This is the light pad. This is also a light pad, but it's a little bit longer. This is a regular pad. This would be equivalent to your regular maxi pad. Same, it has a higher thickness. It's made out of a cotton woven top, fleece bottom to stop you from leak throughs. And then in the middle inside, it has cotton absorbency for liners. So you won't have any leaks with those. And this one here is a longer pad. It's either postpartum or for heavy bleeding. So those are the options from Gem Cloth. And I have to tell you, I've used this pad here. This is the regular pad. I used this one day when I was on a picnic and I didn't have a chance to go to the restroom for several hours. And I didn't even have a leak through with this. And it was amazing. I used that on like the first or second day of my cycle. And I was very pleased that, you know, I had no leaks or anything. I just folded it up, put it in my bag to go. And when I got home, did what I had to do. I'll discuss that in another post because I don't want to make this too long. And these are also panty liners. These are really thin. They feel like underwear. And you put these in your pad as panty liners and you just wash them instead of investing in and having to always buy panty liners every time you go to the store. You just wash those and you have them for years to come. So check out next Monday's post. I will talk more in detail in post about these and where you can purchase them from. Lastly, the last thing I want to talk about for you women that love to clean and you love your Swiffers, here is the Rubbermaid Reveal Mop. This is like the most economical mop on the market right now. It has a reusable pad here. This is a reusable pad for cleaning the floor. You just take that off and wash it. And it has this bottle here that you fill up your own solution in. Here's my newer one because I actually purchased two of them
just to have extra backup, just in case. And you see it says you can refill it. It has the reusable bottom part. It also has a mop, a dust mop head, but that one's dirty right now, so that's why I didn't show it to you. But that's all that I wanted to show you all about how I'm trying to be greener in my life, small things that I'm doing that you could also do. I hope you really enjoyed this video and that you see that recycling and being greener is not as overwhelming. You just take baby steps to start. And here's another way that we're green. You see these, that's our Craigslist finds, you know, so we also fix those things up as well. And if you don't want to go that far, I think this is a small area where you could start just to be a little bit more cautious in your life and a little bit more green. I really hope you all enjoyed this video and stuck through it. Look for updates on the blog. Bye.